A very pleasant good evening to all our viewers, especially viewers of BC TV. This is an edition of our regular program, Muslim American Perspectives. So welcome to this edition of Muslim American Perspectives. As the name suggests, we make an earnest effort and also endeavor and strive to bridge the ever-widening gulf. In other words, we can very easily say that it is an interfaith harmony show where we try to promote peace, interfaith harmony, goodwill, social justice, and above all, tolerance. Tolerance of others. Tolerance of others' viewpoint. And if we do that, this country would really be a shining city on a hill. All my Muslim friends, on one-to-one basis, they always say that Islam projects and practices peace. Of course. And I accept that. Yes. Islam is, as some people put it, a paragon of peace. But let's be honest. Talk is cheap. There's a time to talk and there is a time to walk. Now is the time to walk the walk more than ever before. Walk the walk and loudly, clearly, and vociferously let the world know, and especially our fellow Americans who are recipients of good life here, freedom of speech, freedom of practicing religion, all liberties that you can talk of. And I always try to encourage, stand up and be counted. Silence is deafness. And sometimes silence is interpreted as if you are an abettor. When I use that word, I say as if you condone that. And I would like, and all my American friends, they love immigrants. I am an immigrant. And this is the land of opportunity. And also, this is the land of free and brave. Wherever there is a problem in any country, economic problems, earthquake, or floods, or some other calamity, this good nation that opened its doors for us, and people, especially people, opened their arms, and here we are. Our dreams have come true. So this is a very generous country. This is a very generous nation. The people are loving and generous. going to the aid of people who are suffering. But now is the time for all of us together, especially in this atmosphere. Hey, tell our friends, you know, make sure they understand. Stand up and be counted. Be loud and be clear. And let us openly tell and advocate that Islam is peace, and we must show it by actions. What we see here in even in US, in Europe, it is unbelievable. Islam is a faith and religion of peace. And in the name of religion, when you kill, maim, and destroy all those who do not concur and believe in your values, there is the advocacy of jihad. Why? That is the dilemma. That is what the people here in America, our American brothers and sisters, are American citizens. I am now American citizens, and I am very proud. I thank God. And we should all be thanking God, whatever God we worship. Hey, this is great. But be seen. You must be seen and must be heard that, oh, this is not Islam. And openly say things that are not Islamic. People who are doing all these things. And what is going on? In the Islamic Belt, especially, from Indonesia to all the way to Turkey, there is so much persecution going on. And again, this persecution is in the name of their faith, Islam. And I believe very strongly that when you do something like that, you are doing your faith a disfavor, because people can very easily interpret it. You say one thing from one end of the mouth, and you say another thing, you do another thing from the other end of your mouth. So there has to be some kind of consistency. Let us be united and love this country and support the values of this country, because the values of this country are what? Love one another, be helpful to one another. The family values. Don't just all the time say, oh, this is a decadent society. This is a sexually charged society. And what happens is, the children in the home, they hear that. And somehow, they are tainted by that. Oh yeah, maybe this is a decadent society. Yes, this is a sexually charged society. And God bless all everybody and anybody in this country. And we should always be thankful. Thankful that this country is here. Somebody, a Muslim friend of mine, few years back, he said, you know, religion aside, faith aside, but this is really a paradise. Paradise that we yearn and long for after we say goodbye to this earth. And he was elaborating, okay, what would you have in paradise? You will have in paradise in abundance, and you have here in abundance. Everything that is mentioned that we will get in paradise. But it's here. And I have been so impressed that I couldn't believe it. So much so, one day we were having a cup of tea. We who are from that part of the world, South Asia, we love our tea. Very sweet tea. It has to be very sweet and a lot of milk and cream in it. And he said, you know, you gave me a passage from the New Testament, a story of Lazarus. And he said that he wishes that he could go back as Lazarus and tell his people that there is a paradise. It didn't make much sense, but I did get the gist of it, what he was trying to say. This evening, we are going to do a ceremony because there is so much persecution going on around the world, and especially in the Islamic Belt, from Indonesia to Turkey, in the name of religion. So, what is persecution? Persecution is killing. Persecution is forced conversions. Persecution is denial of health care. Persecution is also with denial of health with rape. Simple as that. So, what we are going to do this evening, show our solidarity with all those who have been persecuted. We are not talking about one particular religion. We are talking about all those who are persecuted, killed, maimed, and destroyed, and in the name of religion. And here I have, okay, if I can manage this, I am going to light this candle. In the memory of those who have been persecuted in the Islamic Belt. And I have mentioned already the forms of persecution. And so this candle is lit to in the memory of those who have suffered, who have died. And we pray for them that the good Lord would reward them. Then, on my right, I'm lighting this candle in the memory of a malicious, inhuman crime that has been committed in Nigeria. For the last few years, Nigerian young girls from their boarding schools or wherever, they are kidnapped. And our media tells us Nigerian girls, nobody cares and has the courage to say all these girls who are kidnapped and picked up from their schools, they're Christian girls. It is such a horrendous crime. Boko Haram. Boko Haram and Al-Shabaab, they openly claim it. And what is happening in Nigeria? These Christian girls, they are taken as captives, they become sex slaves, and then they are impregnated on person to produce jihadists. It's unbelievable. Because when a Christian is persecuted, it's not popular to talk about that. When a Christian is persecuted, it's not politically correct. I don't know why. We must have the courage to call evil an evil. Good, good. But somehow our media feels that, oh, since it's not popular, since it's not political crap, why bother? And maybe they feel the ratings would go down. And third candle that I am going to light okay, this particular candle I am, then there was light, these two are pretty good, but anyway, this particular candle is in the memory of that massacre that happened on Easter Sunday, when Christian families with children, women, old men, men, they were massacred in a park in Lahore, Pakistan. I've been to that park. I've been there in that city. But why were they killed and maimed? In a corner of this park in Lahore, city of Lahore, in the biggest province in Pakistan, they were just singing Easter songs. They were merrymaking. They were happy. They were happy. And there were some people who didn't like that. And so they decided to throw bombs there, resulting into exact figure 69 killed and over 200 injured. And I am lighting this candle in their memory, especially the children, the women. Of course, the massacre here, and we as children of God must accept our responsibility. What is our responsibility as human beings? All those who believe in God Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and all humankind, and all life, and all life on this earth. What is our responsibility? And I challenge everybody, anybody, to accept the responsibility of loving one another, caring about one another. When you see a wrong, point that out. When you see an evil, point it out with loud and clear voice. Don't be timid. the good Lord. And for Muslims, I must say, there is more that unites Christians and Muslims than divides. Both are children of Abraham, and Muslims like to call it Ibrahim. And if he is the father, he is the head of the clan, then why this gulf, this ever-widening gulf between the two, I like to call it sometimes, cousins? What went wrong? What is Christian? And some people, Muslims, my friend, they very happily and proudly say, Jesus Christ was never crucified. Because they say, how could such a beloved, they call Jesus prophet of God, be crucified? There was somebody else, they claim, was crucified. Somebody else was crucified. And they revere. In Holy Quran, there are four chapters, four books that talk about Jesus, that talk about Mary, Maryam they call it, Maryam they call her. And it is so beautiful. What happened, where happened, how it happened, that this ever-widening gulf took its shape, and there is no end in sight that this would somehow be mitigated. But we must make an effort, honestly and sincerely, with honesty of thought and honesty of purpose, to bridge this ever-widening gulf. We can do it if we can have all this technology. If we can do wonders, why it is so difficult? Loving fellow being is not that difficult. Caring about another person who is in need, why say, hey, I am better than you? What does that prove? Do you think your faith says that, hey, yeah, you are better than him? God created man. He created man and woman after his own image. And who are we to say that, oh, I am better than him? So let us make an earnest effort to bridge this ever-widening gulf and stop this persecution that is going on. Economic persecution, physical persecution, lack of health, denial of health persecution to those who do not belong. Because I believe the tent of Islam is big enough that all can live under it. So my friends, I am recipient of that great generosity, and I wish all of you that we will appreciate this shining city on the hill. Thank you for watching us. Thank you, BCTV. God bless you, and have a great, wonderful day.